everybody, meteorologist Liz McGiffin here, and today I want to show you a pretty easy experiment with stuff you probably already have at home to talk about our water cycle. So here's what you're going to need for this. You're going to need, of course, some water, a little bit of food coloring, a Sharpie. Now these two are optional, but it makes the experiment a little bit more fun and easier to see what's going on. A little bit of tape, a baggie that you can see through that also has the Ziploc on the top, not the kind that'll fold over. And I went ahead and did the next step for us. I decorated the baggie. And since we're talking about the water cycle, we want to add things like, of course, water at the bottom. I at least attempted to make some ocean waves in there. Add a few clouds in the sky and maybe put a sun up in the corner. After you've put your art skills to the test, I need you to take the water. Now you don't need very much water for this. Depending on the size of your bag, it's going to vary. Just add enough so that you have about an inch or so of water in the bottom. So for me, that's going to be just enough. That kind of covers up those little waves that I made. Maybe I'll add just a little bit more for good measure. Next thing that you're going to do, again, this is optional if you have food coloring. This will help us to see the water a little bit better. I want you to take the food coloring, add just a few drops. Since we don't have much water, maybe about 3 or 4 drops will be enough. Give it just a little bit of a splash so you get the color all in there. And then I need you to seal off the bag. Try to get most of the air out of the bag as well when you zip it up. It doesn't have to be completely airtight, but it should look like this when you're done. Next thing that I need you to do is take the baggie and find a spot on the window. Come outside, find a place where your baggie's going to be in direct sunlight, tape it onto the window, and now we wait. So now that our baggie's had some time in the sun, you can see we're kind of in a shaded area now. I want to talk to you about what's going on and how this represents just a small snippet of what goes on with our atmosphere and the water cycle. Obviously, for the water cycle to happen, you have to have the water. So that's what's going on down in the bottom. Now, in order for the water to get all the way up into the top of the baggie, well, that's a process called evaporation. And that's actually why we drew this little sun up in the corner. What happens with evaporation is it's the process of the sun warming up the earth. And as it does so, the water eventually gets so warm that it goes from a liquid into a gas. And since that warmer gas is less dense, it works its way right back up to the top of the baggie where it kind of gets capped off. Now, after it cools, it starts to condense. And as it condenses, well, that's how we start to get clouds. So clouds, they're basically made of a whole bunch of little water droplets, like what you can see right in there. Now, eventually what happens is that as the clouds get really big and puffy, basically what's happening is that it collects more and more of those water droplets, essentially making it way too heavy to hold on to anymore. And eventually what happens is the process of precipitation, or where the water droplets work their way right back down toward the earth again. Now the precipitation, of course, that happens in the form of rain, of sleet, or snow, all depending on the temperature. And what happens after those water droplets hit the ground? Well, eventually they're going to collect back up into a big body of water, like a lake or a river. And then we start that process all over again of evaporation, condensation, and then precipitation.